Welcome back. So there is a fourth FIR against Twitter now. In this fight between the government as well as Twitter, who is right as of this moment? That's the big question as of this moment. See, the point is that you have to follow the law of the land. And in some of these FIRs, particularly the latest, which is in a matter of pornography, you have to follow the law. There is no other alternative. Yesterday, there was a point of a wrong map. You can't show the map of a country wrong. You can't show Jammu Kashmir as well as Ladakh as a separate country. It's not right. An action will follow. There are rules in this country. But the point is, there is also an allegation. Many people say that the government is now picking on Twitter a lot. Is that the truth? Is that right? Let's put this to a debate. Jitin Jain, cybersecurity expert. We also have Mr. PKD Nambia, political analyst, supports the BJP, and Adil Singh Bhopre, spokesperson of the Congress Party. Apar Gupta, lawyer and executive director of Internet Freedom Foundation, is also now with us. Mr. Nambiar, what do you think? Do you think that this is being done deliberately to teach Twitter a lesson? That's why these FIRs, because if you ask me individually for the crimes and the manner in which it is being highlighted, you can't show India's map incorrectly. It is wrong. But when you see these FIRs and put them in a context, it almost appears as if the government is getting back at Twitter.
I think the Twitter issue is nothing to do with ego. It is purely, as you mentioned in your initial comment, that every organization who functions in a country need to follow the law of the land. NDTV follows it. My company follows it. Rest all the people who functions in this country follows it. Unfortunately, Twitter has been in a mood that they are behaving as if like they are the superpower of this world and the law of our country does not matter to them. They have a double standard when it comes to in multiple cases. When it comes to, they have one standard for the capital the riots in the capitals, and whereas they have a different standard when it comes to the problem is that I think the Twitter is a multinational company which is doing its business in India. We should not be, including you and me, should not be propagate them as if they are something like a godly stuff or something which we cannot function without. That is not the kind of an image I think knowingly or unknowingly we are trying to give.
Okay.
Let us not give
sure,
that.
Sure, sure. Adil is now back with us.
Very quickly.
I'll come back to you. We lost the line to Adil Singh Bhopre, so let me quickly go back to you. Sorry, Adil. You were saying.
Let me pick up from where I left. This constant squabbling between the Bharatiya Janata Party and Twitter is just not done. It is unacceptable. Government of India represents the will of the people.
Are these FIRs squabbling? Do you think it's an ego battle, these FIRs?
Ego, no, please understand. I think you have to look at it deeper. As far as the infractions of law in the FIR is concerned, the Congress Party is unequivocally clear that any attempt to distort the map of the Indian Republic or any attempt to propagate any material which is obscene is just not acceptable. The law of the land must take its course. But having said this, you have to look at the issue slightly deeper. There is an attempt by the government of India to control Twitter. And on the other hand, Twitter appears to be working on the other extreme. It is like a pendulum which is swinging to both extremes. This is not how
there is no meeting ground, you mean?
1 billion people function. Government of India must...
But where does the onus lie? Who is responsible to come to this meeting ground?
Well, as far as Twitter, even as far as the Congress Party is concerned, the intermediary rules are certainly an infraction of our rights under Article 19. But the proper way to go about doing it is taking the matter to court and having it settled by a constitutional court. At the same time, Sanket, let's not lose sight, and we've had this debate with you earlier, even the BJP government is attempting to control Twitter. That is why I say this pendulum is swinging to two extremes, which is not good for a democratic country like India.
Okay.
Democracy, freedom of expression is our soft part. At the same time...
Sanket, can I just...
Wait, one moment.
Can I complete, please? My final point.
Yeah.
At the same time, the distortion of the Indian map seems to be happening with repeated frequency. It is not that this has happened for the first time. So therefore, the government of India must seek a plausible explanation. This cannot go on like this.
Absolutely.
We
okay.
are very conscious, and Twitter needs to be sensitive to our territorial integrity and our concerns.
Apar Gupta as well as Jitin Jain, one by one. Apar, I want to come to you now. You've seen the political side of the discourse, which basically says that Adil feels that this is has boiled down to an ego battle. Right? That is what it has come down to. But where should that meeting ground be?
That meeting ground needs to emerge from clear basis of regulation. FIRs as well as bans, which have frequently now become a part of conversation regarding technology platforms, is a very blunt instrument in my view, which represents that we as a democratic country have not been able to devise a legislation to regulate online platforms in a proper manner, articulate the harms, impose fines and penalties, and also issue directions. This is not only specific to Twitter. We've seen the same event occur with respect to TikTok, and also a very large moral panic around OTT streaming, and Amazon was also a part of that. Technology platforms today serve millions of Indians. They are used in an inherent manner to our professional and personal lives. And I think it is very important and timely for us to look at the Information Technology Act, update it, discuss this in Parliament, look at the specific harms and go about it while acknowledging that social media is a daily part of our lives.
Because the conversation
again, which I'm saying is proceeding right now, is emerging from a perspective which does not fix any problem. These FIRs do not fix any long-term
well
problem.
Well said. I think that's a very significant point that has been made. Jitin Jain, would you concur? Would you agree?
Yes, I agree 100% with Apar. And in my opinion, these piecemeal legislations or rules will solve the problem in short term. But if you look at the long-term problem of regulating big tech in India, I think the time has come that, like two other sectors which are very critical to India's economy, telecom and finance, we have SEBI and we have TRAI. The time has come to bring in a regulator in the IT sector, on the technology sector in India, which will deal with the entire, you know, landscape of this big tech every day. Now, second, I don't think it is an ego battle between the government or Twitter. I think it is now, you know, appears that Twitter is now on the collision course with the Parliament of India. It is the statement of Twitter that our policies are superior or equivalent to the Indian laws and they are more important was made not to the government or BJP, but to the Parliamentary Standing Committee, which has got members from across political spectrum. So I think when you know, Congress spokesman Adil Saab says that probably, you know, he says that if FIRs are technically right, then action must be taken. And I think we can all debate, deliberate, but can he give a better option that how do you deal with this problem of
Adil?
Twitter?
Adil, would you like to respond?
I'll
bring in penalties tomorrow, they will refuse to pay. What if they refuse to? I mean, there is no provision today for penalties, but even if you bring in data protection law.
Adil, what do you do when a company becomes so gigantic that they think that they are a law unto themselves? I think that's the point that Jitin is making. That's what has happened to big tech.
Let me answer this. Technology is a great leverer, and technology has indeed helped India. Let's not lose sight of that. At the same time, this is not a black and white issue, or we can find a black and white solution. I don't think Mr. Jain will disagree that the government of India and the BJP more particularly has repeatedly tried to control social media or control bad press. At the same time, the Congress party is very clear that any social media conglomerate must abide by the law of the land. So if there is a distortion of the Indian map, the law of the land must take its course. Why I say it's an ego battle is that tweets and statements from ministers without an agenda or an objective to find the solution is not helping our cause. We are becoming a global laughing stock. So therefore, this extreme position
is not helping us. I think this is the problem, that if government was to take a stringent action, a definitive action tomorrow, it may so appear, you know, happen that several political parties might turn up and say that, look, you are trying to control them, arm twist them, and you might side up with them. This is the whole dilemma. If our political class cannot speak in one voice against this big tech, then merely asking government to take strong action and stop giving the sermon will not work.
Okay.
I think can you promise running out of time,
so quick comments. Yes.
First of all,
Mr. Nambiar, you heard what Mr. Bhopari had to say. He feels that the actual purpose is not to regulate big tech, but is to control big tech and control the narrative. That's the motive.
Where is the question of controlling? In fact, this is the sad part of it, that we are politicizing a stuff. The issue is simple, that tomorrow morning when Sanket Upadhyay's account is being suspended, where will Sanket Upadhyay will go and complain to? Will he be going to a court? Or you wanted to go to the Twitter and approach Twitter and say that why did you do so? So there needs to be a mechanism within NDTV. If there is a content which we are displaying right now, if it goes wrong, at least NDTV will say that you can go and put a complaint here or whatever it may be. In the case of Twitter, they are saying that we are not answerable to anybody. We will decide. If there is a wrong message is being posted in the Twitter, which is against the national interest. It is
so who's Twitter accountable to? I think that's the point that you're making, and they should be accountable. The honest answer should be they should be accountable to Indian law. Okay. Apar Gupta wanted to come in. Last comment, please. Yes.
The first thing is Twitter has an inherent problem and several of them. However, if the perception is being created that Twitter does not respond to any requests from public authorities in India, that is incorrect and not borne. In fact, the requests which are there for content takedowns as well as requests for user information
have been honored. Some of them have been honored.
Largely, you can go and view their transparency reports, not only Twitter, but several large platforms. This does not take away from the fact there are problems. They need to be regulated. Okay. The second thing is the enforcement, which is being sought by the government of India, and there's some reflection within it that the government
Since you are a lawyer, tell me if there is a problem.
One moment. Gentlemen, I've run out of time.
Two tenses more.
I've run out of time. Heart stop on this discussion. Thank you very much. It's going to continue even further because I'm pretty sure that the provocation or the confrontation is not over.